Hello, this is Billy. In part one of the video for the Basin style passive vertical hydroponics tower, we have stepped up the basins, put in the standpipe, and have the 15 millimeter pipes to connect the tower together. In this part two, we will continue to talk about the ducts, the rubber pipe, and the flow valve, and how we put everything together. Okay, so now we need to set up the rubber duct for the irrigation to feed the nutrient to the roof tank. First, we need to do is drill a hole in this standpipe. We need to mark. Where to drill the hole. So supposedly when the standpipe is inside the tank, we want the hole to be drilled just beneath the surface and not too close to the bottom, because that will create a leakage. So you want to drill close to the top of the growth tank, but not above it, because we want it to be hidden by the foam. So is the foam, right? So we want to drill the hole just beneath the foam, so that we can expose the duct, and the duct can be connected to the flow valve. Okay, so we can hide everything inside. It will be nice that way. So I have marked this line here that is just below the surface of the foam, and we can start the drilling. Okay. So it's done. So we need 2 8 millimeter pipe. So the inner diameter is 8 millimeter. So a short piece of 4 millimeter pipe. The inside diameter is 4 millimeter. So we need this type of T-joint with one side, the both side for the 8 millimeter pipe, and then the middle part is for the 4 millimeter pipe. So we'll just put the 8 millimeter pipe in until it reaches the first knob, so it can be secured. Ideally, it should get closer to the second knob as well. Yeah. Let me try hold it. Yeah, then it will be secure this way. And then we can slide it in and just let this part stood out. We'll connect the fin pipe. And so we will insert it here and then push it in. Okay, that's it. And then we cover it with the foam board. Everything will be hidden inside. We can then connect it to the flow valve like this. Like this, and you can place the flow valve inside. Okay. And then that will be all we need to do. The flow valve will be inside controlling the water flow to reach only 1 inch and not above it, so we have more space for the roots to exchange the gas for a healthier growth.
I find the base not stable enough, so I mounted the standpipe using screws to a big square board with a big surface area so it can stand straight and not fall down easily. And now I'm fitting the end stop to the end of the central duct so the water won't be draining out of the tank. So the idea is all the nutrient will be absorbed by the plants Nothing get recycled, nothing get wasted and drained. So there's an end stop there to make sure water will not be drained. Okay, so this is the central pipe that I mounted on the square board. So it will be secure and strict.
I'm going to show you how to make the stand for the grow lights that you can put into your vertical hydroponic tower. So first we need this cross joint and this connector for 15 millimeter PVC. This cross joint is for the 25 millimeter PVC. First we short it up, cut it into four pieces like this and line it into this shape. Then we can use some PVC glue to glue it to the four sides. To allow us to glue it easily, we will use these duct tapes to secure it in place.
Then we will use this PVC glue to glue them together. Then we will let it dry for around 12 hours.
I'm now connecting the Growlight cable. So first, I route this cable through this hole in the bottom tank. It will be high enough so it will not be leakage. And then we route it through this hole in the standpipe. And then it will rise all the way to the very top nutrient tank. I changed to a bigger nutrient tank so it can hold more nutrients. It's an 8-liter tank. I have painted with a layer of brown coffee color paint and then overlay that with a layer of white paint so it looks like a bit pinkish. It's like the, what I did with the other tanks. And then I connect this type of PVC pipes, which consists of two pipes, an inner pipe of 20 millimeter and the outer pipe of 25 millimeter. So I can slide this in and out to adjust the distance. The last step is to just secure it in the cross joint here and then connect it to the other end of this power cable. So this is how we connect the power cord. There are four LED grow lights. Each one has this type of socket. And then there are three wires from each grow light. They are merged by color into these three bunches. The life, the neutral, and the earth. And then it connects to the corresponding wire here. Turn up the pipe and connect this PVC pipe. Yeah, like this. That's how it looks after lighting up. Finally completed setting up and transplanting the vegetable to this basin style vertical hydroponics, passive hydroponics tower. So this is the nutrient tank. I haven't covered it yet, so this is where the nutrient starts. It is fed through a central duct here to a flow valve here to each layer and to the bottom. So we have the LED grow lights 4 feet hanging from the top. This is a 5-layer system, 5 basins were used, plus a bucket at the top for nutrients. I'm growing the salad vegetable as well as the lettuce. I'll give you an update later after a week.